what the community looks like.
Show me what community looks like.
This is what community looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Show me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Yeah!
I surely hope that their ignorance and hate can be washed away so that they may see their privilege. So you must be wondering why I am talking about privilege right now. Because they did not know what it feels like to have to earn our basic rights in this land. A right that we rightfully should have as human beings.
And let's all be clear. The young people who we are talking about right now are being vilified. Right now are terrified. Terrified. And I hate being fueled by this idea that we should point at each other and blame each other. And we are not going to let them divide us. We are not going to let them divide us. This is a fight that is about justice. This is a fight that we promised that we would not share that information with ICE. And what's happening right now? I dare say we may not be keeping our promise, and that is wrong. I sit on many committees in the United States Senate, including the Homeland Security Committee. And I asked each one of the people that has been appointed to run the Department of Homeland Security, will you keep your promise to these young people and not share their information with ICE? And they would not commit. They would not commit. And the point that we've been making there and here is that weeks of energy that you have knowing we will see this through. We are going to see this through. We will get beyond this moment in time. We will get to the right place. It's just a matter of time. So keep fighting, keep marching, keep shouting. Se se puede.
The right side of history?
Yeah!
All right, now to continue on.
I am optimistic because there's been bipartisan support, and there's been long-standing bipartisan that because of the frankly arbitrary nature of what the administration has done, specifically DACA, and you know the abrupt nature of it, there's a renewed sense of urgency to pass the treatment. But I'm working, for example, with Lindsey Graham, and there are others. I think that a lot of the folks in the Congress, and in particular in the Senate, they understand that we really should not make this a partisan issue because it is not. And so I'm feeling optimistic.
Senator, there are reports that the Trump administration is now in the with Donald Trump's nominee, Christian Nielsen, in the next Homeland Security. Did you have any initial?
I just heard about it, so I don't know the background. I don't know much about it, but I will say because I've been reviewing each of the nominees. One, Secretary Kelly, when he was appointed to the chief staff, and then the acting person, that I've been disappointed with each of the nominees so far. I don't know about her, so I can't speak to her, but part of the disappointment has been that when questioned, they were unwilling to make a commitment that they would keep the government and America's promise to the DACA kids that we would not share their information with ICE. It's a very serious matter. In fact, each time I've called up the document that has the heading of the United States government, where we told these kids if they apply for DACA, we would not share their information with ICE. And each time they've been unwilling to keep that commitment. So I'll keep an open mind as it relates to this, this nominee, but I can tell you that the track record is not good.
You good? All right. We have time for maybe one more question.
Quick question, Anna. this is unrelated to DACA, but Boy Scouts of America just announced that they're going to open Cub Scouts to girls. Do you have a reaction?
I just heard, and I think it's great news. It's about time, but I think it's great news that girls are going to have equal access to all that the Boy Scouts of America has been able to offer the young people in our country. It's a wonderful opportunity. I'm glad they made the decision.
Workplace harassment now being renewed again. What is your reaction to all of this news, and how do you move forward?
Well, I mean, I'm deeply troubled by the most recent incident, and I will say, well, it's not even recent, it's been going on here for years. There is still a lot of work to be done in terms of addressing sexual harassment in the workplace, on the streets. It's a very real issue still for our country, and one of the best things that we can do is encourage that we talk about it openly. One of the best things we can do is to recognize that the victims of that kind of behavior should not be questioned about what they may have done to contribute to the situation, because that is just absolutely inappropriate and unfair. And we need to just bring this out to the light. It happens much more often than folks realize, and the most important thing we can do is talk about it and then address it immediately and make sure that they're going to be serious and severe consequences when it happens, because it is a serious problem.
Last question to talk about the topic. Is there an interview? Do you see an interview? Does it seem like the Trump administration wants to do anything that doesn't involve it? What do you think is your plan?
Listen, I believe we need to pass the agreement, and I think very strongly. We have got to create a path for citizenship for these young people. And again, they gave so much information about themselves, a clear vetting. We're talking about a population of young people who are in college, who are serving in our military, who are working in Fortune 100 companies. And we need to keep our promise to them. In terms of passing the DREAM Act, there should be no strings attached to it. And it's just the right thing to do to pass on the DREAM Act. And that's how I feel.
All right, I think that's it. Thank you guys so much.
Okay, thanks guys. Thank you.
No more last questions.
No more third. Another question.
I keep getting, I was getting texts.
Just heard the name.
Oh my goodness. She'll stand with the Sherlock.
Thank you.